The crash has only just begun. The federal debt is at an all-time high, and the average individual is broke and living paycheck to paycheck. Cheap money is the only thing propping up the economy. Fake money from the Fed. The American standard of living was based on the petrodollar pricing monopoly, which is now gone with the wind. This thing is going to get really ugly, and the things the government is doing to help is only going to make it worse. We are now in a negative feedback loop, beginning with small businesses going out of business and their properties sitting empty. The loans on those properties will go into default. Property prices will fall as lenders try to recover at least some of their losses by selling below market. The falling of property values will wipe out property equity of other businesses, causing the weaker ones to have credit problems and eventually fail also. Much of our economy is service-based, and much of these services are basically non-essential. People now being paid more to be on unemployment than to work will not want to lose money by going back to work, making it that much harder on small businesses. By the time the government stops paying people more to collect unemployment than work, many small businesses will be broke and gone. Bigger corporate-owned businesses who have gotten slammed by this crisis will be looking at replacing workers with automation wherever they can. Machines do not get quarantined, sick, or transmit the disease to customers. By the time these unemployment programs run out, many of the jobs people are looking to return to will be gone forever. Only criminal syndicates get the bailout. They are the backbone of this psychopath parasitic debt-based system. 50 million people are still waiting for their $1,200, but Mnuchin's corrupt friends received tens of trillions in an instant. It is a race to the bottom as the death spiral tightens up. The vicious cycle feeds on itself. More businesses die, can't pay back loans, more employees gone. Those loans are only forgiven if you keep all employees. With business cut by 75%, it will be impossible to do, and if cut 100%, well, it's game over. We ain't seen anything yet. Wait till the supply lines are completely foobar, and people have run out whatever money they can pull down in the next couple of months. Continuous layoffs as more businesses fold, rampant inflation for those goods still in supply. It will be like taking a Wall Street tough heroin junkie and throwing him in detox without so much as a candy bar and a cigarette. At some point, we're going to hit either a grid net down condition, a complete supply chain break, or some hungry people start pillaging. The 2020 shitshow is just beginning. I can't even visualize how bad it will be. This is the worst economic collapse in history. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. You are here for your daily dose of the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. The new normal will be anything but normal. There will never be a complete return to the old way of life. We can't restart in a normal way. 6 feet or 2 meter distancing. You can scratch about half of all business offices. I have no idea how I'll do that. Everybody in home office? It doesn't work. And because everybody has the same problems, not a single company can work at 100%. 30% if they're lucky. And how do you do that with your expense budgets and salaries all calculated at a normal way of working? Fire 60%? And how do you give the same service? What if everybody fires 60%, how about the purchasing power? We can't work like this. You can't change these structures just because you want to. And the longer they wait to give workable solutions, this situation will get worse. And keeping everybody at home with free money, not on this planet. Eventually, inflation will force everybody out, and only idiots believe this will last forever, and there are a lot of idiots like that. It is doubtful GM and Ford can last 3 more months even if they resume limited production. Even with bailouts, Boeing may not make it either, or GE. They all did stock buybacks to make the wealthy top 10% even richer. Now they are all nearly dead. Nothing saved for an emergency. The automakers won't be able to give their vehicles away. They will sit rusting in empty lots across the US while the fools in Congress come up with another cash for clunkers genius idea. You can bet these companies all have huge bank loans, bond issues, and massive pension liabilities. They cannot pay on any of that. No way. Will Congress let them all go bankrupt as they should? The banks are already seeing the handwriting on the wall. The big banks will all need bailouts again. The Fed can pump the stock market up with more trillions, but the rot is still there underneath. All the phony new stuff just gets piled on top of the rot, and it all decays away together. If we open it all up and COVID wave 2 hits us hard, we may not make it through. The financial nonsense, money printing, credit creation on the scale of the last couple of months illustrates the root problem of our economy and why things will only get worse. 99.99% of the population has completely lost the connection between real money and real wealth. It really is that simple. And anyone who knows the history of money, real money, and how it functions in the trade of real goods and services in a free market, knows what I mean. Borrowing money isn't the same as income. That's a hard lesson for many people and companies. The stock market, as and always, has been a pyramid scheme. Nothing is real. Why does it even matter if the market is up? Unless you're an insider, your exit timing will suck if still in the casino. I don't even pay attention to the market. It's dead, rotting and stinking. Watch the real world. Things cracking. Supply chains. Meats, gas, toilet paper. They blamed the toilet paper shortage on hoarders. It'll be fine in a week. Right. Gas? Just shot up 40 cents a gallon. 1.38 to 1.79. The real world is where we live, the stock market is dreamland. Pork has exploded in price this week. Already. The market is going to crash. I guarantee it. What you have to understand is that everything has two values. An intrinsic value, which is what something is actually worth based on its fundamentals, and a perceived value based on what people think something is worth based on speculation. Depressions happen when the perceived value of assets gets too far out of line with reality. At some point, people stop believing a house is worth half your life's earnings or that a stock is worth 50 or 100 years of best-case scenario earnings. This is the same old game being played out over and over again. It is no different than when 400 years ago people believed tulips were worth more than gold. At least until they stopped believing. This is what central banks are for. It always was what they were for. Too many believe fancily printed notes or, worse, computerized digits are wealth. They are simple minds, apparently incapable of conceiving of symbolism. So when the symbols geometrically increase, their simple minds tell them that the things thusly symbolized must have increased simultaneously. And they cannot conceive how the symbols are given at no cost robbed them. Currency is symbolic. When the symbols increase faster than physical goods, the owners of goods are being robbed. It is so simple. There's a madness in the world, for it to be possible to misunderstand it. The Fed operates under the illusion that it will buy everything if required. It's psychology bluffing. What they have already done and will do in the future is a small fraction of what is required to stop the crash and reset that is to come. They know that. But they have convinced fools that they have such real power. All the Fed can do is bluff to borrow more time. The time is running out. We will pay the price for our stupidity and the Fed's insanity, which has allowed their close circle of friends, the 1%ers, to get phenomenally rich by looting the rest of us. At some point, this whole house of cards is going to collapse. Fake everything from our elected liars and money printers. The only thing that matters in this pandemic is the fast march towards digital totalitarianism. Because when this is all done, we will all be living in a cashless society, with some truly pissed off serfs running around wanting some revenge, and bad too. That's not even mentioning the gripping depression, poverty, and food shortages. While market and economic crashes come and go. What we're facing here is a spiritual, social and societal crash. We're disintegrating and losing social cohesion. Wealth is simply not possible under such circumstances. Even Henry Ford acknowledged the social need for high-paying jobs and how it would benefit his company. We're losing everything that makes wealth possible. The greatest error in national history was allowing the Fed to come into being and not abolishing it once we figured out the Fed did not have the Americans' best interest in mind. What's happening today just validates my theory that the dollar has already collapsed. BRICS have pulled the plug on the dollar and are using the cross-border inter-bank payment system as their global clearing system, bypassing SWIFT. The virus is a cover for this huge financial global transition. The role of the propaganda media is to hide the truth and provide a cover to explain why rapid inflation is on its way. If people knew the dollar is toast, you would have panic. If they think it's because of a fake pandemic, they stay inside glued to the TV watching celebrities eating gourmet ice cream and cooking and dancing in their kitchens. How and when the Fed unloads all of the stock and bonds they have on their balance sheet is a good question. Then it's over. And I do mean over. Grow up. Be independent. Learn how to live without all the crap you think you must have. F the Joneses, you don't need to keep up with them. Once a debt slave, most likely always a debt slave. Can't pay a bill? Do without. Dump the friggin' fancy phone for a cheap one. Horror of horrors, a landline. Pay something towards your utilities. You'll find it amazing, but, usually, a half payment will keep things on for a month or so. Eat less, cook more at home. Make your own goddamned coffee. It's much cheaper. Drive less even though gas is cheaper. You don't need a subscription service to watch a movie. Borrow a DVD from a buddy. Loan what you got in return. Read a book. Do a physical hobby. If you own land, start farming. I started this on a property I own as a hobby. And because the food tasted way better than the stores, now I think I might need to feed people with it. Save someone, you know. Don't let them go homeless. Let them live with you and take care of them. Let's vote to eliminate property tax on building extra dwellings on your property so you can save your friends from sleeping in their cars. If God has blessed you, then save as many as you can. This is going to get bad, and what good is being self-sufficient if your friends fall? Financial nonsense is not the economy. Go out and work, do something productive. Gold in US dollar terms has gone up 550% in the last 20 years. Silver, in US dollar terms, has gone up 230%. What else do you need to know? We need to return to our heritage American, Main Street economy, and get rid of this contrived house of cards, debt, Wall Street casino economy, that benefited only the banksters, and our politicians all bought and paid for with the middle class wealth. Some may be wondering why the Fed has targeted the middle class. Because, as Willie Sutton once replied when asked why he robbed banks, because that's where the money is. The globalists don't want more money. They do want maximum control. By continuing to impoverish the masses, they aim to keep the masses from causing any trouble. Smother all spontaneously rebellions by reducing us to survival mode. To accomplish this, they're quite happy to all kill geese laying golden eggs, which they ratcheted into high gear after 2008. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, subscribe. And please take some time to subscribe to my backup channels, I do upload videos there too. You'll find the links in the description box. You will also find a PayPal link if you want to make a donation. Thank you wholeheartedly to all those of you who have already donated. Stay safe and healthy, friends.